Welcome to ENT student to understand the complications and management in ENT head and neck cases.
You are a true surgeon from the moment you are able to deal with your complications.
Whenever you deal the complications, so surgery is done by a surgeon, it's okay, but the ability to deal the complications is the most important thing. According to this Owen W. Wang and Steen, very important. It's not the surgery, it's the complication management that is more important.
Introduction and definition. A complication following head and neck surgery can be defined as an adverse event that impacts on the patient's recovery, alternatively described as a possible side effect of surgery. An awareness of the possible complications enable the surgeon to provide informed consent when discussing surgery with the patient. While not all conceivable complications can be covered, particular emphasis may be placed on certain outcomes depending on the individual and their comorbidities.
So accordingly, what is important is it is an adverse effect. So when you are doing something, there will be a side effect or an adverse effect, so which impacts the patient's recovery. It affects on the recovery of the patient, number one, and it can be described as a side effect possibly. So whenever it is a adverse event, it is called as a side effect. An awareness of possible complications. Whenever you are doing a surgery, you should know what are all the possible complications that can come. And while taking for the patient, you have to go for informed consent. You have to ask for the consent of the patient. Consent of the patient, and you should discuss the patient about this consent and possible complications. And when not all complications can be conceived or covered, at least certain outcomes can be known, and it is based on the comorbidities of the individual, like, you know, CVS compliance, CNS compliance, respiratory system compliance. All these are important while you are dealing about the complications. You should keep it in mind.
As a general rule, minor but frequently occurring problems such as auricular paresthesia after parotidectomy, rarer but more significant complications such as facial nerve damage. Remember that clear documentation of such preoperative discussions will mitigate possible future medical legal issues.
So when you are doing a parotidectomy because of greater auricular nerve damage, you can have auricular paresthesia. So as you can have, the lady will not be able to wear the earrings properly after parotidectomy. You should inform the lady. And there is always a chance of facial nerve damage even during parotidectomy when you are removing this parotid gland. So the facial nerve can get damaged. So facial nerve paralysis should be informed, consent should be taken. And remember that clear documentation. So everything you should write on the case sheet. Everything should be written on the case sheet for the sake of medical legal issues. The case sheet will save you. The case sheet will be saving you from all the medical legal problems. Never forget to write the things in case sheet. Case sheet is a very important document. When you do some counseling to the patient, always write it in the case sheet. Don't forget.
The incidence of complications will vary from surgeon to surgeon. Some of this variation may be due to differing definitions. For example, what do we mean by a wound infection? Underpinning the ability to quote our own complication rates is personal audit of our work. All surgeons, including trainees, must be active in this regard.
See, mistakes are common for human, errors are common, and even for surgeons. You should be dare enough to accept the mistakes. You should be dare enough to accept the mistakes, and you should know how to cover them. You cannot say that you are mistakeless. So you should know how to cover them. You should manage the complications, and it is something called as audit. When you are doing 100 cases, how many cases you are having facial nerve palsy? When you are doing 100 cases, how many cases you are having lateral sensorial canal injury? For example, I am telling in ear. You should have in your mind, for example, out of 100 cases, I had one lateral sensorial canal injury. Don't say that I never injured lateral sensorial canal. It is not possible. You should be able to accept it with all the grace, nothing wrong in it. And definitions differ. Even sometimes our sutures also get infected, whether wound infection is there or not. So we should know, all the surgeons, trainees, everyone should be active in this regard. Nothing wrong in accepting the complications. Nobody is 100% perfect, but you should know how to manage the complications. That is the concept of this.
Basic principles will be highlighted. A careful preoperative assessment, meticulous surgical technique, high quality post-operative care, appropriate rehabilitation are the cornerstones of preventing and managing complications. General and specific complications will be discussed on elements of prevention, identification and management.
So what are the basic principles for avoiding the complications? Number one, you have to prevent the complication by knowing the sound anatomy, sound technique of surgery, sound training, sound hands-on, sound cadaver dissection. All these will minimize the mistakes. They will not make it zero. And even then also, in spite of that, you have got a complication, you should be able to manage the complication. For example, total thyroidectomy you have done, there is hypocalcemia because parathyroids are removed. How to manage that complication is more important than why did you remove the parathyroidectomy? That nobody will question you. Okay. And beforehand itself, you should explain to the patient that there is a chance of removal of 4 parathyroid glands, there is a chance of hypocalcemia, there is a chance of tetany, all those things will be there. You should explain to the patient. Okay. How do you know all these things? A careful pre-operative assessment. Think 10 times before you cut one time. Think 10 times before you cut one time. So that means you have to think a lot. Surgery doing is not at all an issue. Preparing the case, whether it is fit for or not, whether it is having any complications, you should be able to communicate the patient whether you are going to have any complications. So think twice to 10 times before you cut one time. One time if you cut, later on you can't do anything. On table you can't go back. Okay. Is number one assessment. Number two, meticulous surgical technique. So whenever you are learning a technique, it's not about doing 100 cases. Doing one case with a proper technique is enough. And number of cases always adding to experience, it does not teach you then. If you are learning a wrong thing in a wrong method, you continue doing that for many cases. If you are doing a right thing for two cases also, the third case you become a better surgeon. And high quality post-operative care. One more thing, surgeon is like father, okay, anesthetist and the one sisters and the patient are like mother. The job of father is just, okay, donating the, so whatever is required. Later on, for 1 year the mother has to take care of the child, until the child is born. So for that reason, surgery is only 1 hour job. But post-operatively when you are doing something, you should be carefully dressing the patient, you should be carefully monitoring the patient for all the IV fluids, for all the antibiotics, for all the dressings, for whatever it is. So that is a tough job. So it's not like you just simply do the surgery and go away. Until the patient comes out of anesthesia, until the patient comes out of GA, you should not leave the patient. That day I was there till the patient came out. You cannot leave the patient and go because you are responsible till the exit of the patient. So anesthetist is taking like mother. Completely they are taking everything. But surgery is a father like job. You have to take care even beyond also. Mother will take care till 1 year or 2 years. But beyond in the life also father has to take care a lot. So that you should keep it in mind. And if anything goes wrong, for example you are doing laryngectomy. How do you do rehabilitation? After removing an organ. So resection is one thing you have to keep it in mind. Number two is rehabilitation. Rehabilitation. Okay. Resection is one thing, number two is rehabilitation. Okay, once you remove that, you have to rehabilitate the patient. So that is resection followed by reconstruction. When you are removing an organ, you are putting a graft or a flap. That is reconstruction. And after that, something going wrong, you have to go for how do you rehabilitate the patient. General complications are there, specific complications are there for a particular case. For any case, there can be general complications and specific complications will be there. These are all things you have to keep it in mind. And you should know how to prevent the complications. Number one, identify the complications. When you are doing some surgery, for example, a nerve is cut, you should be able to identify it. How would you identify it? You will identify only with prior experience. You cannot identify it just like that. You won't know it. So, judgment comes with experience. Good judgment comes with experience. What type of experience? Bad experiences. So, for bad experiences, you have to do bad things in the case. So whenever you are doing bad things, you have to know it prior from a senior person that whether it is correct or not. And instead of knowing also, you will do some mistakes. Then you will know the output of that. When you damage the recurrent laryngeal, you don't know the output. Then next time in the next case, of course gone is gone, you cannot come back. But next case you should be improving yourself. So that is how you have to manage yourself. and at the end of the day patient management. So these many things are there for understanding the complications, for understanding the complication. Now we'll go for the basic classification of these complications.
These can be initially classified as general or specific. General relates to the risk of undergoing any surgical procedure. Specific relates to the particular operation in question. These will be discussed.
So number one complication will be general complications. Number two complications will be specific complications. As far as thing is concerned, the surgery itself is a complication. When you are doing something, when you are cutting something, it is a complication always. There is no other option, you have to cut. When you are cutting, you have got general complications. Like for example, patient has already a cardiac problem, or patient has already a respiratory problem, or COVID nowadays. That is, you can keep it as general. And specifically, when you are doing facial nerve surgery, you will not have hypoplasm or palsy. So you should know whether specifically ear complication means there will be there. There will not be any voice change in ear surgeries. So those are something like specific complication. Any surgical procedure is a risk. Patient should be exposed. Once again, you should train the patient that surgery, after surgery everything is not like normal. It may be normal or near normal. Okay. Not like before. Specific relates to particular operation in question. What are all will be discussed.
In addition, complications may be classified as early, occurring during or within 24 hours of surgery. Intermediate, complications arise during the early days or weeks post-operatively. Late complications generally occur months or years after surgery.
So you are having it late. It is months and years after surgery. Late is months and years after surgery. Early is within 24 hours. Okay. Like primary hemorrhage, reaction hemorrhage, secondary hemorrhage, translation. We should keep it in mind. Primary is during the surgery itself. Okay, reactionary is within 24 hours and secondary within 7 days, as you know in transrectomy. So you can say early complications, they occur in 24 hours duration, within one day. So by the way, we do surgery today and come tomorrow, that is 24 hour duration, that is early complications. And intermediate complications is early days or weeks, okay, till 1 day to 7 day minimum or more weeks, okay. And late complications comes for months and years after surgery. Months and years after surgery.
Classification of complications, general and specific, early, intermediate and late, local and systemic, major and minor.
As we could see, general complications and specific complications we have done already. So early is within 24 hours, as you could see, and intermediate is 1 day to 7 day or weeks. Intermediate is weeks. And late complications is months to years. Late complications is months to years. Months to years, you should keep it in mind. The complications can be a local complication. The complication can be a systemic complication. The complication can be a major complication. The complication can be a minor complication. So this is how the classification of complications has to be done.
Prevention and evaluation. Patients undergoing head and neck surgery usually have a history of tobacco and alcohol consumption, likely to suffer from both cardiovascular and respiratory disease. These have a significant impact on recovery from surgery. Important part of preoperative evaluation.
Whether it's having a smoking and alcohol in history, tobacco consumption, that is directly related to your cardiovascular and respiratory disease. And recovery is also indirectly influencing. Okay, smoker will have what? Slow amount of recovery. And you should be doing it all the preoperative evaluation. Before surgery itself, you should evaluate them.
Advice should be sought from the anesthetist involved who recommend further medical assessment. Smoking cessation has a positive effect on postoperative wound healing. Several tools exist for the global assessment of patient's fitness.
So you have to go for a PAC. As we know, we go for a PAC for anesthetist's advice because he can do the medical assessment there. Medical assessment can be done there. Okay. So medical assessment done there, and then smoking cessation has a positive effect. So you have to stop smoking, has a positive effect on wound healing. Smoker's wound heals late. And several tools exist for the global assessment of patient's fitness. Patient fitness you can do by many assessment systems. So that we'll see in the next video. Thank you for watching part 1 of our complications and their management by ENT student.